Yeah. What's the intro like? Am I introing with you guys or after you guys?
This could be the intro. We could just start talking, and this could, because I am recording.
It flies.
So
it
we
flies.
Could we right. could just say
so we're
we
in.
Do an untraditional start.
Start
and
it.
Just start right now.
Start it.
We're starting. This is the Ned's Classified Podcast, dude.
Yeah, welcome back, Nedheads.
This is a cold open.
Yeah.
This is the first cold open Ned Pod.
You got your boys, Jake, Kirk. We got a special guest, Will.
Hey, how you doing?
We're recording in my apartment for the first time for, no, not the second time for Ned's.
The first time in a while, though.
First time in a long time. It's
first
been
time
a fucking
in
minute. Will,
it's
you haven't recorded in person for an eternity.
Not,
never
I mean,
with
it's been
me.
Almost a year, I think.
Yeah, because it was like around the time
our
when we started.
Our first show me something.
So yeah.
Will and I have never done a pod in person together.
This is true. Only remotely for Christmas vacation.
One time
which was a
ever.
Fucking shit show.
No, two times.
Yeah.
And my
oh, and Blowout, something. Which is great. Yeah.
And we've also got this sweet video set up.
I'm waving to one. I'm waving to two.
Yeah.
How y'all
hopefully
doing?
It's dynamic as fuck. I've been worrying about it for the past hour and a half.
I walked into this apartment and I was absolutely flabbergasted at the amount of setup that had gone into this podcast before I came
this
in.
This is the most elaborate setup by
easily.
Far.
Easily.
It's pretty wonderful. I'm like, I love it. It's very professional.
It feels right.
Yeah. Shout out to Kirk's mixer board. And are they all Shure microphones?
This is a
just
no,
Jacobs.
Sennheiser, right?
Sennheiser?
Sennheiser. Whatever. I don't know.
Okay. Some Sennheisers, some Shures.
It's all a bunch of
we've
stuff.
We've got some iPhones set up to get the video.
It's
yeah.
just gear.
Yeah, we're geared out.
Well, there might be gearheads out there that listen to the Ned Pod.
Yeah, what's that? Shout out to our audio
I
files.
I got a Yamaha mixer. I got a 2011 MacBook Pro.
You guys both are I mean, this ties right into the episode, too, because it's about music and stuff. You guys are both computer mixers slash, like, music box boys.
Yeah. Yeah, we do that.
And you have the same one, too.
We do have an SP. We both have SP-404s. We make use of that. I think Kirk much more than I do, because he's better at it. I'm getting there.
You've been doing the Jam January, though.
I did. I barely did January. I did three Januaries. I should have done 31. I was minus 28 on that.
Yeah, I mostly just use it as a just kind of a place to hold samples more than anything now. I don't really manipulate them on it much because it's pretty rudimentary and shit.
The trouble with the SP is that you can't – the pitch is terrible on that. Like pitching down and pitching up samples, it sounds like shit.
There's no accuracy to it, but
– it's horrible.
We should just do a music podcast. That'd be good.
Yeah, that would be tough.
I mean, that's on YouTube. I would have nothing to add to it.
That's not true. You had a good Black Keys app.
I did the one. I have a couple albums in mind, too, that I don't know if you've listened to that we'll talk about off mic on the Patreon.
Yeah, fair.
But
like you guys know, in Guide, we trust.
Yes.
We've got some brewskis.
We do.
I'm drinking the Boots with the Fur Strawberry Lager from Swamphead that Kirk brought me down. Shout out, you know. Thanks for bringing it down, Kirk.
Nice limited release.
It's good, too. It's very fruity. Very fruity. I thought it would be more subtle. It's very sweet. It's good, though. It's good.
I've got one from Swamphead, too. It's I don't remember the name of it. It's got cranberry, lime, and orange. It's a nice Berliner. Sour. I'm always sour.
It was tasty.
You're a sour boy.
Yeah, I'm rocking. Like I'm on number three already. I've ran through some other half IPAs from Brooklyn, but now I'm on the King State Mosaic Hazy Double IPA. That's a Tampa brewery. I guess we should shout out the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Big shout out. I got my shirt on.
He's got a shirt on.
With the cam. To date us a little bit, the Bucs just won the Super Bowl, which is fucking crazy. It's one of the greatest moments of my life.
Shout out to dirtbag ass Tom Brady.
Thanks to one man. One man made a whole city feel like they're winners.
Yeah. Well, no, dude, we're Tampa Bay because the Lightning just won. The Rays made it to the World Series this year.
And
the Bucks won. They lost, but they made it. They were champs of the ALC.
Fair.
I mean, it's pretty big. Props. And our soccer team apparently won their conference.
Obviously.
The Rowdies?
Yeah.
No fucking way.
Yeah, they did.
They're terrible, I thought.
They won their conference.
What?
Yeah, if you look it up, like the Tampa Bay thing's been
pretty
big.
That's funny because I was just about to start bandwagoning them because I got an email on the way here about like a Valentine's Day sale for the Rowdies because I've seen them live a few times. I live in St. Pete, like 5 minutes from their stadium. And they're fun to watch live.
In case you guys want to DDoS him.
I've said it before and I'll say it again. Florida rules. Come on now.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know.
Florida's great. People hate on it.
I'm saying.
It's a pretty easy butt of a joke.
Well, I mean, it's a weird state. We live in a weird place.
America's limp penis. I was out in the sun all day today.
You were what?
I was out in the sun.
Nice.
This is true. It is February and it's 75 degrees here.
Yeah. It was 72 yesterday and I was like, damn, it's hot. But in reality, it's beautiful compared to the rest of the country.
I was chatting with some of Malcolm's friends from Indiana. It's 23 degrees there. The low is 7 coming up.
I was just talking to my cousin yesterday who lives up in Indianapolis and it was in the negative degrees.
Indianapolis, right.
There you go.
They were like, a blizzard's coming this week. And I'm like, damn, that sucks. It's 72 degrees out right now.
My dad's upstate New York and he got 12 inches of snow last week. So
it's brutal. But you know what? Florida, I mean, we essentially live in the Caribbean.
Yeah.
I mean, I'll say it again. America's limp penis.
In this area, in this episode.
Flaccid.
If we're Flaccid. Gonna, are you guys ready to get in there?
Oh, no, I'm ready.
Yeah, I'm great.
A little bit.
Do you have any straight up questions for us? Because this is your first episode.
Literally,
of Nets.
First time.
Yeah, so just like the Drake and Josh pod, I had never.
Which you berated. Not the podcast,
did
but
you,
the episode.
Right off the bat, do you like this show better than Drake and Josh?
It's hard to say.
Okay.
There's a fucking lot going on.
Give a gut reaction.
There's a lot going on. It's absurd.
Yeah.
It's a cartoon. Like, and I think it's hard to contextualize because, you know, I'm about to be 30 years old. And so like watching television like this, it's been a very long time since this has been my mode, right? I'm far removed from middle school and high school.
Oh, for sure.
You know, I watch a lot of TV and movies and nothing I watch is anything like this. So it's very strange to come in blind in the middle of the second season and like try to pick up what's going on. Sure. So there's just so much happening.
Yeah. There are definitely a lot of characters and a lot of relationships that you haven't gotten groundwork for.
Yeah. So you think I'm not even really concerned about the characters or the relationships. It's more like the camera work, the audio stings.
The universe.
Oh, dude, the stings.
The stings are absurd. Listen, and the smash cuts, like, there's just so much going on.
The stings is one of the things that has a big history with me and Kirk and Ked as well. Back in high school, we had counted all the stings for a single 15-minute minisode, and there was, like, over 100, right?
Yeah, it was over 100 for
there are so many.
It's, in one minisode. It's insane.
I figured that might have just been a music episode thing.
No, it's just the style of the show.
We tallied, you know? We just did check marks.
Right.
Every time, we just all did our best, and we counted them up, and that was the average. It was like over 100.
Yeah.
Half of the minisode, not the whole 20.
Right,
yeah.
Like 10 minutes.
I think it speaks to like how much they really wanted to make it fast-paced and like a cartoon, right?
It's very fast.
Yeah, it's very cartoony of a show. Like you don't. It's not nearly the same. It's so different than the rest of like the live action Nickelodeon shows.
Yeah, it feels
like Drake and Josh, Zoe's, iCarly. None of them do that.
It feels very different than Drake and Josh, which is
what's
only
Scott
other
Fellows?
Touch point.
He was a different vibe than.
So
than
what's
Dan
the
Schneider.
Deal with this guy? Like what else has he done? Does
don't
he have...
ask that sort of a question. I don't know what the deal with the guy is. Yeah. I don't know what else he's made besides Ned.
I do not know either, but because the main guy for Nickelodeon was Dan Schneider, who is disgraced now.
Is he really?
Did
he touch kids or did he fuck with women?
He touched kids for sure.
God
that's,
damn
that's,
it.
That's the rumor.
That's alleged.
That's fucked.
That's
still
alleged.
He's not put away.
Well, it's alleged. I was actually watching a
this
video
is a
on
country.
It.
Well, we have to be fair. Okay.
Yeah.
You're innocent until proven guilty in America.
But yeah, also believe victims.
Yeah.
If they're credible, for sure.
He was alleged to like
and
hold,
I think these victims are credible
auditions.
By all accounts, right?
He apparently held auditions at like pool party style and would have the kids come. It was very
and
weird.
And be in bathing suits?
Yeah, yeah.
Can I ask you, has Miranda Cosgrove come out against them?
I don't think so.
Because she's the fucking top of the pyramid.
But it's possible. I know that the girl, the blonde girl.
And she's the one that people.
Jeanette McCurdy.
She's the one that people are weird about online, I think. More.
People are only weird about her because she was a normal person and posted like. Pics on Instagram and shit like that.
Wait, so can we draw a line if Dan Schneider is the Jeffrey Epstein of Nickelodeon? What's her name? Not Jeanette McCurdy, the other one.
Miranda Cosgrove.
Is Miranda Cosgrove the Ghislaine Maxwell?
No. Ghislaine Maxwell isn't a child. Wasn't a child.
I know she's not a child, but if she's the head of the pyramid, is she like... Are you saying she was the first victim, or was she the accomplice to pull children
in? She was
not
the accomplice. No way.
I'm not in a position to say anything.
All right.
I don't want
to
alienate our Nickelodeon audience.
Sorry, yeah, I went too deep. That's my bad. I don't know the audience. So.
No, I mean, hey, I'm
sorry, camera two. Sorry, camera one.
This is absolutely a free speech zone. I'm not going to cancel any.
We definitely
are. We don't believe in cancel culture here.
All right, cool.
All right, but definitely Dan Snyder's a piece of shit. But Scott Fellows, I feel like
I think Scott Fellows is Gucci.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know the information, so, you know, if something comes out.
Devin,
let's date this. This is as of February 12th, 2021. Scott Fellows is cool.
He's fine. Comes out tomorrow. He's done all sorts of horrible
shit. We dated it, though, so it's cool. So, yeah, I mean, yeah, this was outrageous. I think there's a lot packed into every episode.
Yeah.
It feels very different structurally than Drake and Josh did. Drake and Josh felt much more like a sitcom.
Yeah.
This feels like a sketch show almost. Like, it was so, like, rat-a-tat. There's just something happening at every point. I think the audio stings definitely give into that.
There's not a whole lot of lull in the episode. Like, no, you're not going to... Yeah.
Yeah, right. It's crazy. I'm very happy to have been here for this particular episode. There's a lot of personal relevancy for Music Class in particular to me, which is just happenstance. I mean, we didn't...
Yeah,
I was supposed to be on last week, which would have been a different episode entirely.
It would have been, yeah, because we did record. But I'm glad that you're on this episode, because did you have musical experience in, like, middle school specifically? Nice.
Yeah, specifically. So I... In my school district, Irvington, New York, Irvington School District, I was in third grade. Kids have the option to join a band, essentially, and, like, pick a musical instrument to focus on. So I was in third grade. I was like, yeah, I'm into this. There was a weird – it's been a long time since then, so my details are kind of fuzzy, but there was a way – like, you had to choose multiple instruments, and then – you would get chosen of something off your list.
I think I kind of, because I was in fourth grade in New York, but this was a couple years after you, but
yeah,
because I played trumpet for like 1 year. I played oboe for even less than that amount of time.
You played the oboe?
Did you have to like first choice, second choice?
That's what I did.
Okay, so yeah. I had to first choice and second choice things, right? I was like not the best student.
Yeah.
So I gamed the system because I wanted to play drums, right?
Sure.
Oh, shit.
That was my choice.
You could hold the beat.
But I put drums as my second choice because I knew that I wasn't good enough in school to get my first choice, which I think I put as saxophone.
Wait,
that
so
that's
the,
how
so
they did it?
Yeah.
Wait, so your choice was based on how good of a student you are?
Something like that.
That's horseshit.
It's absurd, right? And thinking about it now,
who's the governor at the time? Fuck that guy.
Don't know.
Was it Rudy Giuliani? It might have been. No, he was the mayor, right, of New York City?
He was the mayor of New York City, damn. Yeah. This would have been third grade. I mean, it's fucked up, but my reference point is I was in fifth grade when 9/11 happened.
Years ago.
So it was like 99.
That was my sixth birthday.
Yeah.
99.
Because I was born on September 11th.
Yeah, he was.
Fuck's sake. Are you for real?
Yeah.
And our other best friend, Jesse, who's on last... It would have been last week's episode now, right? Or no, 2 weeks, because the Trev episode will come out.
Yeah.
But Jesse was on the podcast, also born September 11th, but a year apart from
you guys her. Do you have two friends who were born September 11th?
Yep.
I was in New York State.
93
Yeah,
and
he was in New York at the time.
Yeah.
Not the city, but...
Yeah, yeah, New York State. That's fine. I also didn't know you were... Were you born in New York?
Yeah.
Catskills,
I knew that.
Albany.
No shit.
In Albany.
Fuck. Oh, wow. That's crazy.
Not me. Tampa Bay my whole life.
Florida boy. Yeah, yeah. My dad lives outside of Albany right now. Okay. Just got his vaccine out of New Paltz. Anyway.
Shout out Papa Stickles, the madman himself.
Shout out David, my boy. Yeah. 77. He just turned 77 last weekend.
What a guy. I got to meet him sometime. Met your mom.
I know. It's like vicious. You have my mom. Good hang. Green bench.
Yeah, that was great. She took an hour and a half to drink a single glass of beer.
Yeah, Cobb and I were sloshed.
I was already hammered off like six beers. And she was like sipping.
They were hitting
like it was a wine.
Yeah, the half liter Pilsners. Yeah. Anyway. So anyway, I put drums second because I wanted to play the drums. And I got the drums.
People love the drums.
So from third grade to 12th grade, I played drums, and I played the bass drum.
My dad plays the drums.
Fuck yeah. Shout out.
He's great at them, too. You guys are always jamming.
Mr. Kirk.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. They're both named Kirk, actually.
Oh, shout out Kirk Senior. Senior. Yeah. So I played drums from third grade to senior year of high school. I had guys come to my house to give me drum lessons. Jim Weingast and Eric Perez were the guys. Shout out to Eric, my boy. And I was in marching band. I was in wind ensemble. And I played the bass drum specifically in those two.
Like just like Cookie in the episode.
Just like Cookie, which I like freaked out when he pulled out the bass drum because that was me. I had the bass drum on the harness and I fucking
Donged it.
I donged it. Yep. I led the rhythm for marching band. Like
you were in marching band.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. I slept in a marching band. We had
just in middle school or in high school as well.
Only in high school. There was no marching band from middle school. So in middle school, I learned to play the drums. Well, elementary school. I started in third grade.
Damn.
And then throughout elementary and middle, I was playing like in concert band. Like you just would play a snare drum or like a bass drum or a timpani.
Jazz band for like over here.
For concert band type shit.
That was in middle school, you said?
Yeah. And then
I was just playing a guitar and jazz band in middle. Not in middle school. No, in high school.
Tight as hell, yeah. So we started in third grade and then, but yeah, I was in concert band throughout high school and middle school and then specifically in high school, marching band. So I played bass drum. You know, as a freshman and sophomore, I'm just like some fuckwit on the bass. But junior year and senior year, I led the rhythm of the march. So like we would march in parades and also like between football games and shit.
Yeah.
You would have like a rhythm, a cadence, we called it, and then we would play songs like Give Me Some Lovin'. Nice. You know, like classic like rock songs.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You did like the marching band rendition.
Right. So there was, this is very, very inside baseball and is really self-indulgent, but it's funny. For the cadence, I like quote unquote made it up, but it was just the drum beat to the song Grindin' by Clips.
What?
Yeah. There's a song called Grindin' by Clips. Who's
Do you know that song, Kirk?
Virginia rap group. Oh, you would probably know it if you heard it. It's a very popular song, but there's like a very distinct drum beat on that song. Okay. And I just adapted that to a bass drum, and we marched to that in between actual songs we played. And like the guy who led the band, Mr. Like Choreo, right? We called it Will's Groove. It was like damn. Absolutely not. It was Pharrell and Chad Hugo's groove.
No, the dude, Neptunes. It was Will's groove.
Nope. But we slapped that thing, and it was hella fun. So yeah, I played bass drum, and I was delighted to see Cookie play the bass drum in this. That's a very long intro for me, who's never been on the pod before.
I want to say that I didn't play a whole lot of music. I was in guitar class for the first semester of ninth
guitar
grade.
Guitar one.
You seem like a guitar one. Player.
Well, I wasn't. And then I transferred out of that because the music teacher was dog shit trash. He didn't know how to play the guitar.
What was his name?
Mr. McFetridge, right?
Fuck you, Mr.
We
McFetridge.
Used to call him Mr. McFetridge because he had like 16 heart attacks.
Oh, you were down here by this point.
Yeah, yeah. We met in ninth grade.
Okay. It's really, see, I mean,
but he was
a sad story
it
for
was
him.
Well.
Did he die?
I don't think so. He's not at the school
He
anymore.
Was a bad teacher. He was there for 1 year, and then you guys got the good band teacher.
Oh, no, he was just not good at his
he
job.
Didn't have any, he didn't have fucking enthusiasm. He was just sleepy all the time. He was sleepy.
Because of the heart attacks.
Sleeping in his office all the time.
How are you going to jazz up a 15-year-old trying to play guitar? Excuse me, guitar, if you're all sleepy?
Yeah, no. So that's a bad fit. So, you know, I switched out, and I went to stagecraft, which was more my gears.
There he is.
I went to see the actors go.
Stagecraft was sick.
But before that, all I had was the recorder, and I didn't learn how to play that. So I really do not have any musical ability at all, except for unless you count Green Day Rock Band in college, which me and Kirk used to rock and drive our neighbors crazy.
If only you had it now.
It's not in the apartment, but it still exists at my parents' house.
Rock Band and Guitar Hero were a delightful fucking time.
Dude, Green Day Rock Band is like one of the best games that's ever been created.
I've never had that. I didn't know that existed. Do they like have full Green Day albums?
Yeah, but it's only the music that slaps. So it's all the stuff from Dookie and American Idiot.
Wow, that's amazing.
And like a couple songs off the album before that's like...
It's their greatest hits.
Yeah. What is the album before Dookie? You know the one I'm talking about with like that sad song on there that everybody plays at the end of graduation.
Before
as we go
Kerplunk?
That's vitamin C
something, but it doesn't matter. It's a great
time
game.
Of our lives.
Yes, that's
all. After Dookie. That's not before Dookie.
I thought it was before.
After Dookie. No, Dookie's their first album, 94.
It's their first full length album.
But anyway, so we start off Ned's
in
D-class.
The show. The Ned starts with a fantasy. Ned's playing electric.
He's greasy
and he's playing fake guitar in this. When he's playing electric guitar when he's in his fantasy, he's very clearly not playing correct. But when
I was going to ask because it looks to me it looks legit.
When he's playing acoustic guitar, he's actually playing the guitar. That's correct.
Because he's doing scales.
He's just playing notes, and I can tell that it's correct. But when he's playing the electric guitar, it's not.
Yeah, right. He just was like noodling hard as fuck.
And it's some other track. He's just doing a track. But
does that piss you off, Kirk?
No, I think it's accurate because it's like that's his fantasy. Right. But when it's his real life, that's actually what it sounds like.
Honestly, that's kind of... Right. That's kind of tight.
That's fair.
I think it works.
Yeah. I'm gonna put a plus.
Shout out to
I'm gonna put a little plus by that. So I shout out to Scott Fellows just because of that.
Scott yeah. Fellows. It was oh, after the rating.
Yeah, we rate each part of the episode.
We do
so
rate
you'll
after
music
we talk
class,
about it, though.
You'll
1 to 10?
Rate it at the end. After talking about it.
Out
right.
of 10, yeah.
1 to
yes,
10.
Out of 10 weasels.
1 to 10 weasels.
Cool. Weasels. All right, gotcha.
There was a weasel in this
episode. You'll be cued.
There hasn't been weasel for the past fucking 3-4 episodes.
It was a groundhog, though, to be fair.
Uh-uh.
No, that is a weasel.
It's a ferret.
It's a ferret. It's a ferret.
Okay.
When you get a close-up of it, you'll be able to tell it's a ferret. They do close-up sometimes.
But that was a clear Caddyshack reference. Are we talking about the same moment?
We are.
The guy in the window in the classroom?
Yes. But the thing is that it could be a Caddyshack rip. But,
it was definitely a Caddyshack reference.
But this is a
recurring
theme,
gag.
This is a theme that's been the entire show.
Really?
Like, the weasel is
Gordy
arch
versus
enemy.
Weasel. The weasel is also the school president.
Yes.
What?
So
there was a competition.
So Martin Corley is the VP, aka he's the puppet. Or well,
there was a recycling contest. Whoever could get the most recyclables.
Now we're jumping around episodes. Yeah,
right?
The recycling. Well, yeah, the recycling.
That determined
episode.
It, right?
This
or
is
no?
fucking crazy.
Well,
no, that's just another thing that happened.
That's just a thing that happened. That's why I was so thrown by it.
I'm completely. All
right. So let me just
oh
say,
my God.
When I saw what's his name, Gordy, the
yeah.
janitor.
Yeah, Gordy.
When I saw Gordy in the window with the bucket hat. Massive Bill Murray
oh,
Caddyshack
he had a
energy.
Hat on?
He did
yeah, for sure.
He had like leaves on top of the bucket hat
yeah,
and was like hiding.
For sure.
Caddyshack's a bad movie.
I haven't seen it.
I haven't seen it since I was a kid.
It's not funny.
It's great as
that's
a kid.
That's the
now,
kind of movie,
dude.
That's the kind
that's
of movie.
That's a Trevor movie.
Trevor would bring us.
That's a Trevor movie that you would both hate.
And we'd both
yeah.
pan. And I already know I don't like it.
But it's it was fun when I was 10.
No.
Yes.
No,
as
Adam Sandler movies are funny when you're 10.
No.
Caddyshack's bad.
Adam
it's
Sandler was even overrated as a 10-year-old.
It's only good if you're a dad from the 80s.
I'm also about
or
to be
Trevor.
I'm older than you. I'm about to be 30.
When were you born?
91.
You're not born in the 80s. There you go.
Caddyshack was funny when I was 12.
You're barely older than me. I was born in 94.
I'm 3 years 95. Is significant,
not
dude.
Not that big.
That's a third of
a
decade.
40 is around the corner for me.
Yeet. Anyway.
Yeah, where, so everyone
do
is,
we go chronological or we just kind of jump around?
You
for
can
these?
Jump around whenever
I
want to
say. The teacher says, you know, because Ned is like fucking around in the music class. That's the opening scene of the episode. Ned wants to be a rock star without putting the work in. Classic.
Yeah, and the music teacher, he's very monotone.
This
you know, he
a,
doesn't inspire
this is
greatness.
A rock and roll fantasy class, Ned.
That guy fucking sucked.
Well.
He's a bum.
He did go about things a lot of things the wrong way, but I think he's got a good heart, but I think he's misguided.
Sorry.
Like
I think
Sweeney.
Sorry. His acting sucked.
Yeah,
he
he's
was
flat.
A fucking
he's flat.
Terrible actor.
Yeah.
Why
yeah.
did like he was green screened for the first few shots? Like those like
that I didn't
severe
notice.
Close-ups of Mr.
They
Gibson
do those.
And there's people in the background. He looked like he was on a green screen.
I think it's just part of his he's supposed to be this weird surreal almost character.
He's also a guy that's never seen again. The music
never
appreciation
seen
teacher.
Never seen before.
This
never
is the
again.
First time he's appeared.
Yeah.
Yes.
But the
that's
music
nuts.
The music appreciation teacher is a reoccurring character. The guy with the beard comb
with
over.
With the beard hair, yeah.
He used to teach a different class. What did he teach before?
Just music.
He looked like
no,
he,
but he's always just like in the hallway. He's like a teacher. He's just a guy.
No, but he's been the teacher of a class before that was not a music class.
I'm gonna
think it was another language.
No.
I think it was another language. I think it was a foreign language.
We're gonna need the netheads to come out and archive that, see if that's legitimate.
He looked like the teacher of the next half of the episode. I thought it was the same guy.
Sweeney?
Yeah.
No, it's not that.
The science
Comover.
Teacher?
Yeah.
No, they're totally different. No, okay. No.
That's I Mr. know the comb over, but I thought just it was him minus the fucking absurd
Sweeney,
hair piece.
Sweeney's he's the most reoccurring teacher in the entire show. He's like an evil science type guy.
Interesting.
Mad scientist.
I just would like to say, since we're talking about the music appreciation teacher, A, that's a fucking dope ass class, it sounds like. I would love to just listen to music and write papers about it. That's what I did.
Do you think
college.
They were writing papers?
No, of course not. They're taking quizzes or some bullshit. But two things. He had a portrait of himself
I saw that
on the
in
back
the
wall of
yeah.
the classroom. And also, on the chalkboard, when he's talking specifically to Ned, there's like music notes written out, and there's words above it, and it just says, bow, wow, wow. And
also,
obviously, it's not bow, wow, wow, yippee, yo, yippee, yay,
yeah,
Snoop Dogg's in the motherfucking house.
It yeah, it be. Is.
It can't be.
Why wouldn't it be?
Because you can't say motherfucker on Nickelodeon. The word after the second wow was not.
What was it?
Yippee. I don't know. You didn't see it.
I also want to mention this same teacher, the comb over teacher. He's wearing like a 70s like pimpin' leisure suit.
He looks like Shaft.
It's a leisure suit.
Yeah. He looks like Shaft.
He looks like Leisure Suit Larry.
He's got chains. Great point. He's got chains outside.
How could you compare him to Shaft?
I was just thinking 70s pimp. It's much more in line with what Kirk is saying. Leisure Suit Larry, the maligned video
those
game
games.
Series. Me either. Always wanted to. Looked super horny.
I'm sure they're on Steam. I could probably download
them. They definitely are.
That could be good.
But Ned is now a musician. He's a musician, singer, songwriter.
Oh, and can we do the shout of TRL? TRL's in this episode, which
without
is also,
Carson Daly.
Yes, without Carson Daly. It is also a thing that happens to Drake and Josh. They go to TRL in the movie, the Drake and Josh Go Hollywood, bad movie, during the rewatch. Mostly blame Trevor on that. He wasn't paying attention during the podcast.
I would I'd like to say I'm jumping off the topic. I had a segue.
Or wherever you got
to
go.
Yeah, I had a segue, but I lost it because I'm already pretty drunk. Simon.
Pizza's coming soon.
Simon's, what the fuck's on Simon's glasses?
Simon Nelson Cook?
He's a cyborg. He is a cyborg.
Yeah, he has an
That's
ass printer.
Canon?
Yeah,
That's
he has canon. An ass printer. He's got the,
you saw that. You were confused about that.
He hasn't seen the vision, though. He hasn't
I have
seen
a
the,
note.
He hasn't seen the boo, boo, boo,
so,
boo,
like,
boo.
What's vision. That? So, first question. What's that little thing off the right side of his glasses?
If you plop that down, that's when cyborg activity starts really going ham. That's when he can pull up.
This is a real thing?
Yeah, that's when he can start pulling up Google Chrome windows, essentially.
He hacks the computer systems of the school. So
with his glasses?
He's changed the cafeteria lunch menu.
Will, there was an episode where he was a substitute teacher for classes for an entire week because he added himself to the substitute teacher catalog.
That's outrageous. And then, yeah, the ass printer. He just has a full laptop and printer in his
it's
backpack?
In his ass. No, in his ass.
It's in his pants.
It's in his butthole or between his butt crack?
It's in his pants. He, like, rips it out of his pants.
He just, like, pulled a sheet of data out of his back, and I was like, what the fuck is
well,
happening?
Well, usually he does, like, a little dance, and he wiggles it out, and
he
it comes out.
He does usually do that.
So
he
that
was
makes
very,
you, that makes
he
you
was very
asshole.
Nonchalant
makes,
about it
when he
it
does the
time.
Wiggle, it makes you seem like it's coming out of his asshole.
Yeah,
yeah,
that's saying,
yeah. Yeah, he's trying to get it out.
But
he
didn't he do
was
it
very
time.
Nonchalant this time. He just was like,
he whipped it out.
What was a pie chart?
Here's the data.
How do you think
he
might have
had a firmware update?
He might have. Maybe it doesn't, like, buzz his asshole like it did before. It, like, zapped him
a little bit. It's a vibrator, too.
Oh, God.
Yeah, he was crazy. His overacting is very comparable to...
But the
was it... I think it's Josh and Drake and Josh is, like, particularly, like...
Cookie and Josh,
very
I can see you saying they're similar.
Like,
they are very
they do, like, absurd facial expressions and, like, very clearly overact
they
on
capture
purpose.
Your attention, I want to say.
Yeah, it mostly just distracts me and makes me frustrated.
Really?
See, I love Cookie.
So you're, yeah, I love Cook as well. So you're an anti-Cook.
I'm not anti-Cookie.
Because I feel like most people that like the show love Cook.
I'm anti-overacting.
Who is your favorite?
I love
your favorite character from this part of the episode. And that can be major or minor. You know?
From both of the minisodes?
We're talking about both minisodes or just the music class?
If it makes it easier, both of them.
I'm a big Gordy fan. I'm a big Cookie fan.
We've done a lot of Gordy hate.
I love Gordy. Even if I hate on Gordy Tattle, it's because it's fun.
Yeah, that's, Gordy's, you know, super weird to me.
He's a dirtbag.
Morris is my
he's
favorite.
He's hilarious.
I mean, of these, of
Morris,
the whole episode,
one of the most minor characters that's ever existed.
He's the most minor character. He did. He never appears again or before.
He barely says a word.
He was the only person that I was like, ah, that kid's cool. Like Cookie, just does like absurd facial. Like he does great. Absurd faces. Ned was fine, but like his hella greasy and mad flashbacks or imagination flashbacks.
He does
forwards.
That a lot, yeah.
And then Moe's, I don't know, Moe's was just like...
He didn't like Moe's. Right on.
Interesting
take.
So
you're going to get a lot of fucking...
What do you think about the teachers?
They're all trash. Why was there a guy in a Miami Vice outfit?
That
guy
that's Vice
like,
Principal Krubs.
So, okay, so it's Krubs. VP so Krubs. I didn't know he was recurring, right? But in the first episode, like the first half of the episode, he when Ned's on the stairs playing guitar,
yeah,
somebody walks by and drops coins in his hat and says, "Don't quit your day job."
No, he says, "Stay in school."
Stay in school. And I was like, and my note,
they're
my
in
note,
school.
My note is, why was there a Miami Vice quote, "Stay in school," unquote, guy in the school? Like, what the fuck is that dude doing? So obviously it's the vice,
he's
principal.
The vice principal.
Yeah, Vice. Why is he like dressed Miami like that? Vice. That's
so,
what it is.
Oh, that's a good joke, actually.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
No, it's actually all right, one of, cool. It's actually one of the best characters. Like, it's so funny that they just did a random Miami Vice character.
Like, the vice principal is Miami Vice? And
yeah.
That's his whole vibe.
That's
he wears
his
white
thing.
Suits all the time.
One time
that's
they fooled
thing.
Him into like quitting his job, and he said, "I'm finally gonna be able to move to Miami and start a detective agency."
Yeah, he said
okay,
that.
That's actually unbelievable. And my whole opinion has changed.
And every episode, he wears like a different like pastel shirt under his white suit. It's so good, dude. Yeah. It's like one of the most thought out characters in the
Wait,
entire
that's,
show.
That's fucking incredible.
Yeah.
I'm so happy.
Yeah. He's very, it's a
because when
character.
I saw him, I didn't know he was a vice principal yet. He comes up in the second half of the episode and I was like, oh, it's that guy.
Yeah. You
but
just,
for him to be the vice principal and he's a Miami Vice reference for this type of show.
Yeah.
That's impressive. I got to give you credit.
And you just missed, I think the one that we did with Trevor was a very vice principal centric episode too, which was very classic because it was Ned trying to be a vice principal. Well, he didn't want to be, but he was becoming a vice principal. So it
was
very good.
Me.
Yeah. It was good. It's good
this
shit. Vice Principal Krubs, big shout out. One
Krubs.
Of my favorite characters.
What is it? K-R-U-B-S?
Impossible to say. I've never looked
it up. I think
it's
C-R-U-B-B-S.
Krubs.
That's how
like
I spell it.
Oh, fuck. It's like Crockett and Tubbs. Crockett and Tubbs. Wow. It's a real
Holy
deal reference.
Shit.
It's C-R-U-B-B-S.
That is right.
Crockett I haven't seen Miami Vice.
No, you're right. That's
Their names
it.
Are Crockett and Tubbs.
That is
nice.
Correct.
That's fucking phenomenal.
That's crazy.
What is up with what's up with Scott Fellows and his Miami Vice? Like,
Scott Fellows
obsession.
Is like a big Miami Vice head.
Yo, shout out to Scott Fellows. Have y'all seen the Michael Mann Miami Vice remake? Mm-hmm.
No.
Haven't.
With
Colin Farrell and
Jamie
Foxx? Fox,
yeah.
I'm bringing that to the podcast. Shout out to Cross Promo, Show Me Something, in like a month.
If you guys are listening to this and not listening to Show Me Something, you're not a real Harbor Boys fan.
Yeah,
you're not. I mean, really not. But
I mean, check it out.
Oh, you never did the shout out for the guy in the beginning.
Oh, well, it doesn't have to be at the beginning, but we can shout out
Chris Dixon.
Chris Dixon. For commenting
countless
times.
Just staring
times.
At me. We had a bit of a miscommunication last time.
He's trolling us.
He trolled Kirk hard.
Now we got a double camera setup.
I got Chris a text. I got a text from Kirk.
Chris Dixon.
That said, people don't know the video works. But Abby's got a new editing style, which you guys should have seen already with the Show Me Something that's going about to go up. So
yep.
Shit's about to flow real hard. I think it's going to look really good.
Getting back to the episode, though.
Hopefully this looks good.
Yeah, Mr. Gibson. Right? Mr. Gibson has a couple bad takes in the episode, a couple okay takes.
He's
One of
bastard.
His okay takes, he tells Ned he's got to practice his scales.
Got
to
do it.
That's fair.
Yeah.
Do you practice your scales on a daily?
Well, the thing is, I think he's going about telling him how to practice wrong. Practice doesn't have to be boring.
He's been too
that's
aggressive.
That's
horseshit.
Yeah, it's crazy. He is being weird. You know, you can have fun practicing.
Why is he such a bastard?
Why doesn't he just teach him a song? Ned, what kind of song you want to learn? You can just learn a song. And then he's like, oh, man, progress. You know, that's how he's
Yeah,
because
I feel like a lot of like catchy rock songs, aren't they just like a couple of chords in a row?
Yep.
He's being a bastard. But he also tells Cookie that the computer is not an instrument.
Oh, that's
this is just not a good way to like. Why not?
That was one of the biggest burns that's ever hit the both of y'all.
Yeah, because Kirk and I were devastated.
You can use the computer a lot of ways,
right?
But obviously. I feel like you all it doesn't make any sense because you still have to be musically inclined to be able to make music on a computer.
Yeah.
Like I could never make music on the computer like you guys do. Like,
but he says the computer is not a musical instrument, which is bullshit.
It's crazy.
And he full on convinces Cookie that's correct, and by the end of the episode, Cookie's got a fucking triangle, and he's like, this is awesome.
Right.
And it's crazy because he was making fat beats.
He goes from a sweet-ass drum loop on his laptop to the recorder, which he has no fucking idea how to play.
Zero skill.
No one does, because a recorder's not a good instrument.
Recorder's a trash instrument. But then he goes to a triangle, like Kirk said, and then he's like, I'm not even good at the triangle. So
also barely an instrument. Like
No, the triangle he's chill with.
He was okay with it?
The bass drum he has in between there.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's his in-between where he's kind of dope with it, but also he loses control and almost kills someone with it.
Yeah, he's dope, but
the
he rolls
teacher.
Down the stairs and almost
it
kills Mr. Gibson.
Yeah, Raiders of the Lost Ark thing where it piles down everybody.
Shout out Raiders of the Lost Ark.
He does take out Mr. Gibson with it.
Yeah.
Fuck Mr. Gibson.
I mean,
dude.
I'll just say, I mean, I made three.
Mr. Gibson is a beta bitch.
I made three B tapes off of just a computer. Yeah. So fuck Mr. Gibson.
Yeah.
And I think it's one of the craziest things, even like, especially during this time. When, like, people are just starting to, like, solely use the computer to, like, make beats and stuff. It's, like, so crazy.
This wouldn't happen today, I don't think.
I'm surprised it happened then, though. It's, like, 2006. It's, like, how is it? People are making fucking...
He's the last of the old guard.
I think he is. He is the old guard, isn't he? Yeah.
But, like, that whole... So, can we talk about the bit where he becomes, like, a rock star and follows...
He's been a rock star.
I don't
want to
be a
rock star.
He follows Ned around the school, which is very Scrubs-like.
Haven't seen Scrubs.
I don't think. Have you watched Scrubs?
I've
at
seen
all?
Some shows, some episodes. Yeah.
Scrubs has
Scrubs
has like a big musical through line. There's one episode in particular where
I could see that sort of a thing happening in Scrubs.
Yeah, there's there's a musician called named Colin Hay. He was in Men Down Under, the Australian group.
Okay. Never living in a man down.
Yeah.
Men without hats.
Men without hats. Thank you. Something like that. He's in that fucking
the Land Down Under song.
Land Down Under. Yeah, thank you.
It's just the song people know.
Yeah.
He was in a group that sang Land Down Under. Okay. He has a solo career, which has a great like acoustic album. But he's in an episode of Scrubs where he follows JD around, like, just by himself, playing acoustic guitar, singing a song as a bard, singing a song that only JD knows.
Classic.
This gave me big energy of that, with Ned being followed throughout the school. Yeah. By this band led by Mr. Gibson,
but I think
who's in like rockstar
it's actually happening in the universe here.
Really?
Yeah, this is legitimately happening.
They're rolling down the school hallways on a fucking drum kit.
This is the only way that Ned is going to get the
listen.
Message
this is
of
these
the
are
lesson.
These are things that everything that you see essentially on Ned's is happening in reality, in Ned's reality. None of it is almost none of it is dream
no,
sequence.
There's,
we saw
no,
we
no,
saw
no,
a
no.
hint of it. Almost none of it is dream sequence. But we saw a hint.
But it's obvious when it is a dream. Like when he's a rock star. That's because
they always
fantasy.
Wake you up. They always do like the, oh, wake
yes,
up.
Yes. There's been actually entire dream sequence episodes, like the James Bond episode, sick episode.
Yeah, but that episode was one of the best episodes that's ever been created.
One of a kind episode, too. It's not a lot of.
You know, don't go back to see what we actually rated it because I couldn't tell you. You know, it could have been bad.
No, but it's a good episode. Maybe that James Bond movie will come out.
What, the movie? That's never coming out.
Uh-uh.
They postponed it like 45 times.
Yeah.
What are we talking about right now?
James Bond. The
new
newest
one? It's coming out.
No they
time
keep
to die?
It's been postponed
no
again.
Die. Because movie theaters aren't open.
Who cares? Why
they
don't they just
put it online? They can't bust their nut like fucking Tenet did and made no money.
Follow everyone else's lead and put it on HBO Max.
It's not owned by Warner.
Nah,
no, it's owned by their own studio.
Shout out, wait, by the way, Judas and the Black Messiah... Shout out to that movie. It's out on HBO Max this week, as of right now, as of this record, for 4 weeks. Gotta watch it. Daniel Kaluuya.
I think we gotta wrap up this mini-sode. The mini-sode needs to be rated.
Oh, yeah.
We haven't talked about hardly anything of the episode.
I think we covered everything.
Yeah.
In the mini-sode, we have.
You're right.
Will, what are you giving this half of the episode? I want to go to you first. You're going what?
8 out of 10.
A quick 8 out of 10. Kirk, what are you giving it?
I don't know. I guess I'll go 7.5. Strong 7.5.
Right on. I'm gonna bump down again and go 7 out of 10. 7 out of 10.
That's
Weasels.
Fucked.
No, that's solid. That's
strong.
It means
you hate music.
False. 7 out of 10 is pretty good for Ned.
Oh, I wanted to. There's tape on almost all the guitar headstocks.
Yeah.
Tape on like the name. So
no branding.
Name. So they didn't want to pay for that.
But
no,
they
you know
call
what?
Him Mr. Gibson, and Gibson's a guitar, is it not?
He has a brand.
You know what?
Big name.
I got to bump up. I'm going 7.5 out of 10. 7 wasn't right. You're right.
But Ned is like, practice is boring.
No, it's right because I'm thinking about the next episode.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, Ned is like, practice is boring. It's like, practice doesn't have to be boring.
Yeah.
You can
7.5 out of 10.
So Class Clown.
Yes.
This episode fucking sucked a butthole, except for...
It wasn't great.
Except for the Janitor and the Caddyshack reference with the gopher on the window in the classroom.
So are you a Gordy head?
No. But I thought that was cool, because even before the gopher popped up, I was like, this dude has big Bill Murray Caddyshack energy. And then the gopher popped up, and I was like, holy fuck.
Do you know that Gordy slays puss on a reg every weekend?
Not a chance.
Oh, he absolutely does.
You don't know?
He's brought his bimbos in fucking
the man's episode. Rocking fake teeth and a gopher homeboy, and he's hitting?
He's hitting hard.
I don't buy it.
Well, Kirk, you know, you've seen the Fs.
Ladies love him.
That was good.
Is it LL Cool G? Ladies love Cool Gordy?
They do.
Holy shit.
That's
like a plot twist.
I do want to say one last thing on the last part of the episode. Did we talk about Mose and her love with her love affair with Mose?
We didn't talk about it at all. We did not touch on
it. We didn't talk about it at all.
That was fun.
So should we? She had a Mozart arc.
Well, basically,
which was good.
She becomes
I liked
brainwashed
it.
With music. The music makes her fall asleep. She becomes narcoleptic for a period of time. And then she has a conversation with the comb over guy. And he's like, listen, bitch, you got to fucking find the music that fires you up. That's what's going to turn you into a warrior.
Yeah.
So you got to find your war music.
Because he does a thing where, like, he is, like, playing, like, 2-second clips of, like, Mozart songs.
That was cool because that kind of establishes kind of how music tonality, it, like, works as far as,
yeah,
like,
I mean, the show, at the end of the day, is trying to teach you things, right?
That so is, like, how the modes of music, because he does, like, I'm walking through the forest, and it's, like, like, happy music, and he goes, I'm mad, and it's mad music, because it's, like, the different types of,
yeah.
And all of that is influenced by the way that the notes, you know, relate to each other and obviously the way that they're played and everything. The music can have that emotional impact
on
you.
Oh, for sure.
That's, like, beyond linguistic.
Except for people that don't like music, that don't listen to music. Imagine being that kind of person.
There's probably people that...
Big shout out to Trev. No, I'm just kidding. He listens to sea shanties.
But even if you play the happy music, you'd be like, yeah, that sounds happy. Or if you play the
sad
music,
you'd be able to tell.
Like, unless you were, like, actually literally a sociopath and didn't have those sort of wirings in your brain.
Yeah, that would suck. that would not be good. But with this episode, the Class Clown episode, we do get a new character.
Jeff, I'm saying they say this guy Todd is his name. Todd the Class Clown.
Yeah.
We've never fucking seen Todd before.
And he's not funny.
One time. He's not funny, and we've never seen him before, and they acting like he's, like, the most favored kid in the school.
No. You know who the class clown, honestly...
Ned.
It doesn't make any sense why it's not Ned. Like, when they showed him bomb, everybody loves Ned. What are you talking about? Like...
I was surprised by this.
What, about him bombing or about him...
About him not being the quote-unquote class clown.
Because he should be. It doesn't make any sense.
Maybe he doesn't think that he's funny. Maybe he just is trying to be like a self-help guy.
He didn't, because he asked his friends, you guys think I'm funny? They were your best friends. If they don't think you're funny, what kind of friend group is
this? Also, literally, him asking that question made them laugh hysterically.
Because they wanted to push him towards the class clown mode, though. They didn't actually believe he was funny.
You gotta nag him.
Which is the saddest thing.
Class clown.
It's the saddest thing I've ever heard. Imagine being friends with someone that you just don't think is funny.
Not everybody's funny. Like you said, not everybody is funny.
Yeah, I know, but I feel like you find people with the same sense of humor as you at the very least, you know?
There might be people that don't have humor in their lives and they just
That makes me really sad to hear. That makes me really sad, dude.
Wait, the kid who was the class clown, his name's Todd?
Todd.
Was he not just Guy Fieri without the frosted tips?
He was. I mean, he was
Todd
even,
had
he
frosted
was,
tips.
Did he?
Yes.
I just know he had the Hawaiian shirt.
Dude, he was even moving to Ohio, which Guy Fieri's from Ohio.
Fuck. Flavortown. Did you just roll your R on Guy Fieri?
Yeah, Fieri.
Stop it.
Dude, he except
he's from Flavortown.
Except Guy Fieri's from Columbus and Todd's moving to Cleveland. So different technically.
Cleveland trash city. Shout out to Columbus
though. Whoa.
I don't take it back. Columbus.
Have you been to Cleveland?
Of course, my family's from,
I haven't been to
from
Cleveland.
Fucking Cleveland. I have mad family from Ohio.
I was about to challenge you like I had been.
My
there.
Mom is from Elyria, Ohio. We've been to Cleveland multiple times. My sister went to Ohio State University in Columbus.
Dude, I've
Bone
been
Thugs
city.
And Harmony.
I've been to
shout out to Bone Thugs and Harmony. Joke.
I've been to Cincinnati a dozen times, like tons of times, because I have family that lived there.
Bad city.
Cincinnati's fine. It's okay. It's
fine is not
yo,
good.
It's okay.
Yo.
Yeah. I want to go to Cleveland though. I feel like Cleveland
no,
could
you should
be
go
tight.
To Columbus.
I gotta go to that.
I want to go to Columbus too. I've had cousins go to college in both cities.
Columbus fucking
that
slaps.
Sick grocery store.
Jungle Jim's.
Yeah.
Shout out Jungle Jim's, the unofficial sponsor of this Ned episode. It's one of the dopest grocery stores I've ever.
I
been
want
in.
To do mention though that Todd Pants is Sweeney.
Yeah, that's a clown.
And someone else.
Krubs.
He double belts.
Krubs.
Oh, Crockett and Tubbs.
So.
That happens later, though.
That does. Oh. Morris does that. Morris,
I missed. Did I miss the first pants?
The first pants. Todd does the pants. So.
I missed it.
So when Morris does the pants later, it's a throwback to the great Todd.
Yeah, wow. I know, but who is the second guy he's pantsing that you're talking about? You said he pantses two people, no?
No, well, Morris pantses Sweeney pants and Krubs at the same time. Yeah. And then in the beginning of the episode, Sweeney gets pants twice.
Well, Sweeney's a bitch.
He does get
bitched. I think we can say that firmly.
He gets bitched out a lot.
He's a clown. Imagine being a teacher that fucking gets joy of, like, people being sad.
Yeah, he's a sicko.
That means you shouldn't be a teacher.
He's a sick fuck.
You know what I'm saying?
Sometimes he does try to teach them legitimate lessons, though.
Will, have you ever had some sort of evil scientist type teacher?
Like,
truly a bitterly evil person.
No. All my science teachers were pretty chill.
Well, they don't have to be science specifically. I'm talking about the character of an evil scientist, you know?
Yeah. No, I don't. I mean, it's hard for me to put an evil scientist character on a different type of teacher.
Like, imagine an English teacher fucking slamming you down or something.
Oh, yeah. I mean, Miss McCarroll.
No good?
She was trash. Yeah, she came into... This is going to be for the video podcast only, so I apologize to our audio
Shout
listeners.
Shout out, video but, boys.
So, her name was Miss McCardle. She had a weird-ass haircut where it was like a triangle-type deal. But she would always come into classroom like...
Wait, are you...
Woo, woo, woo! Like, holding her books like this. Like, and
like
she,
Mario?
That was like a Mario character.
She would be... out of balance. She would be off balance every time she entered the classroom and, like, potentially spilling her books all over the place. She's the closest I can get to a mad scientist. However...
Did she have, like, an issue with, like, the water and, like, her ears?
Like, her equilibrium?
Where it fucks you
No,
up.
I think she was just a bad teacher.
She was just drunk all the time?
She was just a nut job. And then...
My Spanish teacher in middle school always had beer on him in class.
For real?
We always said it was beer because it was... he had, like, a shaker and it was, like, filled with, like, a yellow liquid with head on it. Like, that's fucking beer.
He
always said it was
beer.
Apple juice.
Or it's piss.
He always said it was apple juice. That shit was for sure
apple
beer.
Juice head doesn't last. It goes away.
Yeah. This guy had just gotten off a divorce, and he was not doing well.
Wow, that's insane.
It was
tell you that?
Yeah. He was constantly talking about his divorce in class.
I can't.
You guys
he was
know
for
what
sure
like to be fucking.
I didn't know it at the time, but now it's really hitting me in. He was
that's
drunk
really
all the time.
Fucked. I can't pinpoint a single teacher who was an alcoholic. However, I can pinpoint one of my science teachers. He taught.
Shout them out.
Geology.
Ooh.
Easy science.
This
class.
Was he taught Earth science, which is AKA
igneous,
AKA
minerals
geology.
Rocks.
Yeah,
it was 10th grade of high school. His name was Ben Kwiatkowski.
You took Earth science in 10th grade?
Yeah, it was. I think it was bio, Earth science, chemistry, and then I 12th grade was like forensics, like a slack off class.
Forensics?
Yeah,
that's tight as hell.
Because I slacked
you
off and I could have done like a real class. Like,
yeah, you guys are dressed up like CSI guys and you're like, there was semen left on the body.
Yeah, because I was not trying to do
There's
science.
There's always semen.
I was like, I'm 17, I don't have to do science. Anyway.
I mean, that's true. Ben, you don't have to roll your eyes, that's facts.
Ben
Who does science at 17?
10th grade, Mr. K, had chronic halitosis.
Ooh. Nice.
Just the worst breath of all time. Coffee breath, had a fat ass mustache, and this is a big shout out to my boy Jake Bernard, who will never ever hear this podcast, but
Jake,
he was a folks. He would try to calm the class down by saying folks, but he would say it like folks.
He had a lateral lisp,
big lisp, and massive coffee breath. The man smelled like absolute dog shit. Wear cargo pants and a cargo pants.
That's a
and
big
sick.
What do you call a cargo shirt? It was like a short sleeve
a
button down. A what?
Is it was it like a Goyabera? Did it have four buttons?
Yes.
I think it might have been a Goyabera.
That.
What the hell is
a
Goyabera? Did
Cuban,
you just make that
it's a
name
Cuban
up?
Shirt with four pockets in it.
He had mad pockets on his shirt. Mad pockets on
what
his
pants.
What did
he have in the pockets?
Fuck rocks. I don't
Coffee
fucking know.
Coffee grounds. To put in his mouth so he can make
just coffee harder. Beans. That man stunk like fucking dog shit.
But shout him out, big shout.
Yeah, sick. Shout out Ben Kwiatkowski.
Did you learn?
I hope no. I hated her science. I hope you're still alive. He's probably not, but he was a good dude.
Damn.
Rip.
Can we
Rip
at least shout
not,
Jake out?
Shout out Jake Bernard, bro. That's
is that,
my guy.
Is that the boy you game with still?
Yeah, we play Rainbow Six Siege. Yeah,
right on.
He's our best pure Siege player. Pure. Me and Matt Magoon are strats. Jake is the gun skill guy.
Jake the snake.
He's a madman. He lives in Indiana, by the way, in Bloomington. So,
Bloomington.
Yeah, not a great place. Indiana's kind of trash.
Gary?
Not Gary. Shout out to Michael Jackson and Freddie Gibbs.
Yeah.
But
Ned does a stand-up routine in the episode, which is like he's got a he's got some nice light wash jeans and a t-shirt
and
suit jacket with the sleeves rolled up.
Yeah,
which is
he's telling Seinfeld jokes. You thought was the look more Seinfeld to you, or was the look more?
I went with Bob Saget as my frame of reference.
He did look very Bob Saget.
Seinfeld, 90s. I don't want to call Bob Saget or Seinfeld a hack, but he's
I think Bob Saget's a hack though. I'll call him a hack. That's Bob Saget's a hack.
That's fair. He's very cringy.
Yeah,
Have you ever seen his stand-up?
No, I've seen enough to know that he's a hack. I've seen The Aristocrats. Have you seen that movie, that documentary?
I haven't seen it, but I've heard about it.
Yeah, they like tell it. It's like the same joke told by multiple comedians.
Yeah,
and Bob Saget's in it, but he's like everyone thinks he's family friendly because
He's
because of Full House.
Yeah.
But he's like one of the dirtiest comics.
That's his thing,
right?
Yeah,
but I think
it's because it's like it's a crutch for him,
right?
Is to just be absurdly dirty,
just talk about dicks and vaginas and assholes and shit.
Yeah. And it's funny because he's the dad of Full House.
Yeah. But I mean, the structure of the jokes of Ned was very Seinfeld. It was very like observational comic type shit.
Cookie reminds me of me a little bit in this episode because he comes out with the soundboard.
Great soundboard.
He has the laugh track. He has the with which is like a lot. You know, he has the
He's like wearing it on his chest with a remote control. Excuse me, a remote control.
Yeah, usually you have the soundboard going, Kirk.
Yeah.
I didn't bring it down here.
That's all right, you know?
Yeah. There's enough stuff here right now. It's complicated enough.
We're wired up.
I usually just, you'll use that when we're chilling, hanging out.
Yeah.
I usually use it on the pod.
You've used it before, though. You used it on the Show Me Something episode. The one
Christmas
ripped the audio. God damn.
Yeah. Had some serious fuzz on it.
That was an exploitation problem.
Yeah,
I was never given a chance to fix it. Gordy's a good roaster in this. He's a good roast comic.
Yeah, Gordy's solid.
He has some snipes.
I don't think they're going to be able to see Pip, but I hope they can.
Damn, they definitely can. He's out of here.
Big stretching.
Pip, come here. Come on the couch.
Gordy explains how the class clown both exposes hypocrisy and challenges the status quo.
That was deep.
That's what a comic, a true comic,
that shit was deep.
A person exposes the truth and the audacity.
Yeah.
He's right. But he also, then he goes, you know, you got to be ridiculous. Like, he's crass. He's a very crass, simple man.
Yeah.
Cook, yeah. He's
Gordy,
crass.
I'm talking about.
Oh. I thought you were talking about with the sound box.
No, I'm talking about Gordy, because Gordy goes on the speech about.
Well, he does the dumb shit with the teeth, which is, it's a bad gag.
But Gordy, that is a bad gag, but he also, he talks about the importance of the class count.
Yeah, which apparently he was.
Of course.
He's got to be. He's got the fake teeth.
How else is he going to get that hot ass?
That's true.
Yeah. So, again, I haven't seen Gordy's hot ass.
He slays.
But, like, I just... why is the janitor always the butt of the joke?
He's not. He's a friend. And he's a confidant.
As someone who is coming into this show, having never seen it before, he felt like the butt of the joke.
No, he's a part of the gang.
He's not the butt of the joke. I don't think they're making fun of Gordy. I think Gordy is
he's
like,
just a slapstick comic.
Gordy's like a wise... He's like a trickster. So he doesn't do his job ever.
No, and he doesn't. It pisses us off every time.
It doesn't, but
you've never
the
seen
time,
him clean a bathroom?
His whole thing is that I'll let the night guy get it.
Yeah, that's like his gag. That's his line.
That's pretty good. I can't argue with that.
Yeah.
That's good.
He never does his work. He just coasts.
I hope that's on cam.
It's definitely not. I wish I could take a picture of it.
Yeah, you're going to have to move that camera if you want to get him on there.
There's
a cat over there, right there.
Yeah, we're talking about Pip right now.
Small boy.
For the podcasters.
They hold class clown auditions for the new class clown. When they're like, what the fuck are we going to do? There's no class clown. Blah, blah, blah. That's kind of funny. Seth comes up. What is Seth's joke? He bonds with it over coconut.
He says, orangey glad I didn't say banana.
Ugh.
And then Coconut Head says the same thing.
Just the word.
I love that Coconut Head says it.
Seth is like, yes.
Seth loves it.
That was good.
It was so funny. That was really funny.
That was good.
Seth is classic. Seth is and
the bullies
Coconut
come
Head
up
recurring.
And do a Three Stooges vaudeville routine. That was kind of a classic.
Very Larry Curly Moe type shit.
It was the exact same routine.
Like, poke the eyes between the fucking fingers and the nose.
It was the same shit. Backpack
Kid is a prop comic.
Awful. Hate it. But so he's elected. Bad. He's elected new class clown.
Fuck Carrot Top. Gets
the gig and then it's...
Yeah.
Immediately, Krubs confiscates his backpack, disarming him of all his comedic ability.
And disarming him from his identity because he is Backpack Kid.
Yeah. Right.
That's his thing.
Wow.
I'm surprised that he didn't just start, he just fades away like Back to the Future.
Yeah, he should have. He should have just like melted or disappeared or something.
Yeah, he melts like.
Like in Raiders.
Right. We always talk about Raiders on the show.
I mean, what else even happens in this episode? I want to say this is a weaker half.
Class Clown is trouble. Morris Adams is a fucking straight A student, but he's just funny. He snipes. He snipes at the right moment.
Will,
he
I want to say that funny... second half is always weaker than first half.
Often.
Really?
Yes.
Because almost always. I very much agree that the second half here sucked a fucking ball.
Sweeney
set.
Has a dope DNA tie. I noticed that. There's a... I'm trying to read what I wrote. What the fuck does that say?
I will say that I was watching the second half of the episode. I was shocked at how little I cared about it after the first one.
Yeah.
And
I don't, so I don't know if that's like a thing of just like, it's a lot for there to be two completely different hard plot lines, or if it's just like, or if it's just they always put the worst plot line second.
Yeah.
Krubs, like, I can't
basically
tell.
Krubs comes in at the end because Sweeney calls in, I want to say, for backup, and because he's calling on like insubordinate students.
Right.
And so Krubs comes in with his sweet helmet, which is the construction hat with
the Devo
siren
hat
on it, which is awesome.
Yeah.
That's when fucking Morris pulls a double pants on Sweeney and Krubs.
You just see him holding two belts up, and I'm like, what are these two belts?
Yeah, he decides, I'm going to be a martyr today.
Yeah.
Pip's fucking on the microphone.
I'm going to fucking be crucified in the name of comedy.
And I think that he's fine with that, because he does say earlier in the episode that if he gets into this shit, that his mom's going to kill him.
Yeah.
Morris.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which is facts.
Yeah, he's in. I looked him up because I recognize him. He's credited as Little JJ.
Who the hell's that?
I don't know, but there's a show, and we're recording off my phone now, so I can't look it up.
Yes.
I'll try Jacob's phone, but there's a show that's like legitimately centered around this dude.
You're not gonna be able to get in it. Not gonna tell you it on cam.
Come on, man. What the fuck? You think someone's going to steal your phone?
You never know, dude.
There was a...
Come on, man.
It was a show that I recognized. So just like, let's spit take and then circle back to me.
Pip is now captured. Or Kirk's now captured.
Yeah, Pip is definitely in the fucking frame now.
He was over here, too. It definitely, if Abby takes a wide shot at that time.
It was just Jordan on Nickelodeon. This dude, Morris, aka Little JJ, he is the main character of this show called Just Jordan.
That's what's up. I think, you know what? Fuck, now that you say that, that does
I feel
sound
like you would
familiar.
Recognize it.
I don't know
yeah.
what show
familiar.
You're talking about.
I feel like you would recognize it. For he was
sure.
also in...
Just Jordan. Yeah.
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 He's the main character of this show. And did he get a full show off of
Vaguely.
Just his appearance here? Maybe.
He might have.
But did he have a full show? Yes, he did. Is that as good as Jet Jackson? No.
This is it as good as Lil Romeo?
This might be contentious for our Nickelodeon viewers because Jet Jackson was a Disney show.
Fuck that shit. That's why I'm talking about Lil Romeo.
Jet Jackson fucking slapped.
I don't know about Jet Jackson, but I do know about
Lil Romeo?
I know about Just Jordan. Jordan. I know about Lil Romeo.
Yeah,
Just Jordan
Master
was also
P.
on... He was in... Beauty Shop. He was in Janky Promoters. He
That's
was on,
where I know him from. I
from
know
Beauty,
from Beauty
Shop.
Yeah.
He was also on the fucking Wild and Out.
I've seen almost no episodes of Wild and Out.
You're not missing much, but he was on there.
They
so
just
shout
do,
out.
Don't they just do like Yo Mama jokes and then it's just
yeah,
like
pretty much
Yo Mama.
Pretty much.
They'll like gonna, they'll
so
spin like a random verse.
Shout
like
out
for a little
Shout
bit.
Out Little JJ.
I think I'm going to give this episode a 6.5.
Oof, that's strong. I was going to say a 4 out of 10.
Whoa. I like that's one of the biggest differences in halves I've ever seen in my life. What did I go? I went a 7.5. I mean, I think I'm going to have to roll with Kirk and go 6.5 out of 10.
This episode's not a 6 out of 10, guys.
I think me and Kirk just rolled same.
We got different standards. We got lower standards.
This shit is bad.
Yo.
The first half was so much better.
The first half was better. That's why we gave it a whole point better.
Yeah, dude.
You're just harsher. So I doubled up. Yeah, you're harsher. So I said 8 out of 10 and 4 out of 10?
Yeah, you doubled hard.
All right, I'm sticking to it.
You're an extreme man.
I like that, though.
Yeah. But yeah, so...
We're just cresting an hour.
Exactly.
Yeah. So it's sick.
That's perfect. Perfect.
You got,
that was an hour?
Yeah.
You got any shouts or anything, Kirk? Or Will? Looking right at you, called you Kirk. Will?
Yeah, I mean, not relevant to this particular episode or show.
Where can we listen to the music?
Oh yeah, I mean, fuck. Yeah, I make music under the name Craft Beats. SoundCloud.com/craft_beats. I've also craftbeats.bandcamp.com. I've been diving into some synth based music. Shout out to Kirk. That man is an inspiration in terms of the output that he has in terms of sample based stuff. So mostly Show Me Something podcast.
Yeah, host on Show Me Something.
Yeah, I'm one of the three hosts of the Show Me Something pod, and that show brings me a lot of joy. So check that out if you want music for whatever fucking reason. Check out the stuff I just mentioned. But I'm glad to be here. Happy to be on as a first time viewer once again via the Drake and Josh pod.
Hell yeah.
Here I am.
Thanks for coming on, and hopefully we should be able to do at least one more tonight. So
I think two.
Hopefully.
I've got the
two would be sloppy.
Check out Kirk Yates at bandcamp.com.
Hell yeah.
Also, we always do this. Hit up at Lady M. Shosters, at Daniel_Curtis_Lee. We know we've seen one of our stories.
He has seen one of our stories now because Abby tagged them all last time.
Fuck yeah.
We're penetrating the
inner just like circle. In Show Me Something when Milo viewed our story multiple. Every time we tag him, he sees our shit.
Milo's the fucking vibing man, bro. That's my boy.
That's sick. At Devin Works Harder, at Pinky Pinkston, of course. At Harbor_Boys.
Yep.
Is where we can be found.
Yeah. Shout out to Pip. Shout out to Maestro. Yep.
I wish I had a promo code or something to give you. I wish I could tell you to go to the Patreon.
We don't. One day maybe we'll have a Patreon, but you know, we got to keep vibing with it. Trevor's been pushing
just
it
show,
hard.
Share the podcast with your friends. It's the best. It's the best.
Yeah, share it. Share
and
it
just
around.
Comment.
Yeah, the comments are great.
Engage.
Shout out.
We'll talk to you.
Kill switch engage.
I mean, I look at the YouTube every single day, so I'll see it for sure.
Yeah.
It's a part of my morning routine. So thank you guys so much for listening, and we'll catch you guys for the next Ned Pod. Stay Neddin' and stay deadin'.
Stay Neddin'.